This is the month of July 2020. This is the month in which there was due date to file income tax returns of income. Income tax returns for the assessment years 2021 for the financial year 1919-20 means from 1/4/2019 to 31/3/2020. But the government has extended the due date for filing the returns of income for the assessment year 2020-21 up to 30th November 2020 due to corona pandemic. And for the any taxpayer who could not file his return of income for the financial year 2018-19 means 1/4/2018 to 31/3/2019 assessment year 2019-20 can file his return of income before 31st July of this year, means before the end of this month, before 31/7/2020. So this is the facility given by, this should have been filed before 31st March. Thus the extension has been given by the Income Tax Department up to 31st July due to corona pandemic. One more advantage is any savings, any benefit. One more relaxation given by the government is any deduction or exemption claimed for deposits or investments made before 31st March has been extended up to 31st July 2020. The reason is because of this pandemic, the people could not make saving investments or savings due to corona pandemic. So that give relaxation to taxpayers. The government has extended the time up to 31st July to claim for the financial year 2019-20. This is the benefit given by the government to the taxpayers for this year, means 2019-20 financial year, assessment year 2020-21. Now let us discuss with the returns of ITRs, income tax return forms, applicable to taxpayers. Last time we were discussing about income tax return 1, that is ITR 1, which is applicable only to employees and having income from one house property, agriculture income less than 5,000 and income from other sources only. Means any SSE, any taxpayer whose income is more than the threshold limits mentioned in applicable for ITR 1 has to go to other returns of income which is applicable to them. So now let us discuss about income tax return 2, that is ITR 2. So this ITR 2 is extended form of ITR 1. This is applicable to all SSEs whose income is more than 50 lakhs, agriculture income more than 5,000 and having income from capital gains, salaries, house property, more than one house, also income from other sources. And one more thing is, this income tax return 2, ITR 2, is applicable only to individuals and HEF who doesn't have income from business. It means this ITR 2 is not applicable to the taxpayers who are having income from business or partnership firm or companies or charitable institutions. It is applicable only to individuals and HEFs. So what are the details to be included in the return of income? What are the details to be included in the provided to file the return of income 2, that is ITR 2? Common or general details of name, father name, status, individual or HEF, address, the PIN number, resident status, means resident, non-resident, residential but not ordinarily resident, and benefit return being filed as a representative or his own return of income, or he is a director of a company or having any shares in any unlisted company shares, official residential phone number is with STD code number, mobile number, and any other person's number also can be added, mobile number for communication. Suppose some people may be age old, they could not operate mobile numbers or they could not operate digital communication, they may give other number also, so that means maybe son or grandson, anybody who can look after the communication with the income tax department. The same way, mail ID also, they can be provided, two mail IDs, alternate mail IDs also can be provided. And I stated earlier, one mail ID can be used for 10 returns of income. Means any member of a family can file the returns of income of their senior citizens, parents, or any taxpayer who could not continue communication with the income tax department digitally. The taxpayer has to give his office address, residential address with landline phone number and STD code. And if it doesn't have a landline number, and any mobile number attached linked to Aadhaar number. Other details required are whether this is the original return or revised return, date of birth, PAN number, Aadhaar card number, ఆధార్ ఎన్రోల్మెంట్ నెంబర్, ఆధార్ కార్డ్ లింక్ టు పాన్ కార్డ్, మెయిల్ ఐడి, ఐ స్టేటెడ్ ఏరియర్ మెయిల్ ఐడి 1 and 2, మీన్స్ ట్యాక్స్ పేయర్స్ మెయిల్ ఐడి అండ్ ఎనీ అదర్ రిలేటివ్స్ మెయిల్ ఐడి, నేచర్ ఆఫ్ ఎంప్లాయ్మెంట్, అమౌంట్ డిపాజిటెడ్ మోర్ దెన్ 1 crore ఇన్ కరెంట్ అకౌంట్, ఫారిన్ ట్రావెల్ ఎక్స్పెన్షన్ మోర్ దెన్ 2 lakhs, ఎలక్ట్రిసిటీ బిల్స్ అబోవ్ రూపీ 1 lakh, డిజిటల్ సిగ్నేచర్, ఫారం 26 AS. దిస్ ఈస్ ద రికార్డ్స్ ఆఫ్ ద ఇన్కమ్ ట్యాక్స్ డిపార్ట్మెంట్ విత్ రిగార్డింగ్ ద టీడీఎస్ మేడ్ బై డిరెక్టర్ ఇన్ ఫేవర్ ఆఫ్ ద డిడక్టీ, మీన్స్ ద ట్యాక్స్ పేయర్, టీసీఎస్ ట్యాక్స్ కలెక్టరేట్ సోర్స్ అండ్ ఆల్సో దేర్ ట్యాన్ నెంబర్, మీన్స్ ద పర్సన్ హూ డిడక్ట్స్ ట్యాక్స్ దేర్ ట్యాన్ నెంబర్. ఆల్ ద డీటెయిల్స్ ఆర్ అవైలబుల్ ఆన్ 26 AS. దట్ ఆల్సో టు బి వెరిఫైడ్, దట్ ఆల్సో టు బి ప్రొవైడెడ్ బై ద ట్యాక్స్ పేయర్ అండ్ డీటెయిల్స్ ఆఫ్ అడ్వాన్స్ ట్యాక్స్ పేడ్ ఆర్ టీడీఎస్ మేడ్ అడ్వాన్స్ ట్యాక్స్ పేడ్, సెల్ఫ్ ఎస్టిమేట్ ట్యాక్స్ పేడ్ అండ్ పాస్పోర్ట్ డీటెయిల్స్, ఇఫ్ ఇట్ ఇస్ అబో అగ్రికల్చర్ ఇన్కమ్ 5 lakhs, వెదర్ ఇట్ ఇస్ అబో 5000, బిలో 5 lakhs, 2 things ఆర్ డిఫరెంట్. ఇప్పుడు ఇఫ్ ఇట్ ఇస్ అబో 5 lakhs, వీ టు గివ్ సమ్ మోర్ డీటెయిల్స్ అండ్ ఇన్కమ్ ఫ్రమ్ ఎనీ సోర్స్ అవుట్ సైడ్ ఇండియా, పర్సన్ హ్యావింగ్ ఇన్వెస్ట్మెంట్స్ అవుట్ సైడ్ ఇండియా, ఇఫ్ హీ గెట్స్ ఎనీ ఇన్కమ్ దట్ ఇన్కమ్ విల్ బి యాడెడ్ ఫర్ రేట్ పర్పస్ అండ్ ద వాట్ ఆర్ ద ట్యాక్స్ పేడ్ ఇన్ అవుట్ ఆఫ్ ద ఇన్ అదర్ కంట్రీ దట్ విల్ బి గివెన్ రిలీఫ్, మీన్స్ దట్ ఈస్ ట్యాక్స్ బెనిఫిట్ అండర్ డబుల్ ట్యాక్స్ ఇన్ అవైడెన్స్ సెగ్మెంట్. ఆల్ దీస్ డీటెయిల్స్ హెస్ టు ప్రొవైడెడ్ వైల్ ఫైలింగ్ ఐటీఆర్ 2. ఆల్సో ఎలాంగ్ విత్ దట్ వాట్ ఆర్ ద ట్యాక్స్ పేయర్ ఇస్ హ్యావింగ్ ఇన్కమ్ విచ్ ఈస్ ఎగ్జెంప్టెడ్ ఫ్రమ్ ట్యాక్స్, దట్ ఇస్ మేబీ అగ్రికల్చర్ ఇన్కమ్ ఆర్ మేబీ ఇన్కమ్ డివిడెండ్స్ బిలో 10 lakhs ఆర్ ఇంట్రెస్ట్ విచ్ ఈస్ ఎగ్జెంప్ట్ ఆల్రెడీ, ఎనీ ఇన్కమ్ రిసీవ్డ్ విచ్ ఈస్ ఎగ్జెంప్ట్ అండర్ వేరియస్ సెట్స్ దట్ ఆల్ షుడ్ బి డిస్క్లోజ్ ఇన్ ద రిటర్న్ ఆఫ్ ఇన్కమ్ అండ్ క్లెయిమ్ కంప్యూటింగ్ ద ట్యాక్సబుల్ ఇన్కమ్. నెక్స్ట్, ఆల్ ద డీటెయిల్స్ ఆఫ్ ఆల్ బ్యాంక్ అకౌంట్స్ విత్ ఐఎఫ్సి కోడ్, బ్యాంక్ నేమ్, బ్రాంచ్ నేమ్, ఆల్ దీస్ డీటెయిల్స్ వీ హ్యావ్ టు గివ్ ఇన్ ద రిటర్న్ ఆఫ్ ఇన్కమ్. అఫ్ కోర్స్ ఇఫ్ ఇట్ ఈస్ ద అకౌంట్ ఈస్ ఇన్ఆపరేటివ్ ఫర్ మోర్ దెన్ 3 years, యూ డి నాట్ గివ్ ద డీటెయిల్స్ బికాస్ దేర్ ఆర్ నో ట్రాన్సాక్షన్స్, యూ డి నాట్ గివ్ ద డీటెయిల్స్. నెక్స్ట్, విత్ రికార్డింగ్ సేవింగ్స్ వెన్ అడ్వాంటేజ్ ఇన్కమ్ ట్యాక్స్ డిడక్షన్స్ గివెన్ ఫర్ సేవింగ్స్ ఆర్ ఇన్వెస్ట్మెంట్స్ మేడ్ బై ట్యాక్స్ పేయర్స్, దట్ ఈస్ పబ్లిక్ ప్రావిడెంట్ ఫండ్, ఎంప్లాయీస్ ప్రావిడెంట్ ఫండ్, బ్యాంక్ ఫిక్స్డ్ డిపాజిట్ అండ్ ఫర్ ట్యాక్స్ బెనిఫిట్, నేషనల్ సేవింగ్స్ సర్టిఫికేట్స్, ఇన్సూరెన్స్ ప్రీమియం, చిల్డ్రన్ ట్యూషన్ ఫీజ్, పెన్షన్ ఫండ్, నేషనల్ పెన్షన్ స్కీమ్ కంట్రిబ్యూషన్, మెడికల్ ఇన్సూరెన్స్ ప్రీమియం, ఎక్స్పెండిచర్ డిఫరెంట్లీ మీన్స్ ఫిజికల్లీ డిజబుల్ డిపెండెంట్స్, ఎక్స్పెండిచర్ అండ్ స్పెసిఫైడ్ డిసీజెస్ ఆఫ్ డిపెండెంట్, ఇంట్రెస్ట్ పేమెంట్స్ ఆన్ ఎడ్యుకేషన్ లోన్, ఇంట్రెస్ట్ పేమెంట్ ఆన్ హౌసింగ్ లోన్ అండ్ డొనేషన్స్ గివెన్ టు చారిటబుల్ ఇన్స్టిట్యూషన్స్, సమ్ డొనేషన్స్ ఆర్ ఎగ్జెంప్ట్ 100%, మేబీ పిఎం రిలీఫ్ ఫండ్ ఆర్ స్టేట్ గవర్నమెంట్ ఎనీ అప్రూవ్డ్ ఇన్స్టిట్యూషన్ దట్ ఈస్ 100% డిడక్షన్స్ గివ్ అవైలబుల్. ఇఫ్ ఇట్ ఈస్ రిజిస్టర్డ్ అండ్ ఎగ్జెంప్టెడ్ దట్ ఈస్ చారిటబుల్ ఇన్స్టిట్యూషన్ రిజిస్టర్డ్ సెక్షన్ 12A, ద డొనేషన్స్ గివెన్ టు దట్ సచ్ ఇన్స్టిట్యూషన్స్ ఆర్ ఎలిజిబుల్ అండర్ సెక్షన్ 80G, దట్ ఇస్ 50% ఆఫ్ డొనేషన్ గివెన్ ఆర్ ఎలిజిబుల్ ఫర్ డిడక్షన్. అండ్ నెక్స్ట్, హౌస్ రెంట్ పేడ్ అప్ టు ₹5000 పర్ మంత్ అండ్ ఇంట్రెస్ట్ ఆన్ సేవింగ్స్ అకౌంట్ అప్ టు 10,000 అండ్ ఇఫ్ ద ట్యాక్స్ పేయర్ ఈస్ సీనియర్ సిటిజన్ మీన్స్ అబో 60 years ఆఫ్ ఏజ్, ఆల్ ఇంట్రెస్ట్ ఆన్ ఆల్ టైప్స్ ఆఫ్ డిపాజిట్స్ మేబీ ఫిక్స్డ్ డిపాజిట్, బ్యాంక్ కరెంట్ అకౌంట్, ఇంట్రెస్ట్ ఆన్ ఫిక్స్డ్ డిపాజిట్స్, రికరెంట్ డిపాజిట్స్ అండ్ బ్యాంక్ డిపాజిట్స్, సేవింగ్స్ అకౌంట్, ఆల్ ఆర్ ఎలిజిబుల్ అప్ టు ₹50,000. డిడక్షన్స్ ఫర్ డిసీజ్ లైక్ బ్లైండ్నెస్, హియరింగ్ ఇంపేర్మెంట్, దర్ ఇస్ అడిషనల్ డిడక్షన్స్ ఆర్ అవైలబుల్ దట్ కెన్ బి క్లెయిమ్డ్ బై ద ట్యాక్స్ పేయర్. నెక్స్ట్, ఆల్ దీస్ ఆల్ ద అబో సైడ్ ఆర్ ద జనరల్ డీటెయిల్స్ రిక్వైర్డ్ టు ఫైల్ ద రిటర్న్ ఆఫ్ ఇన్కమ్ అండ్ టు ఫైల్ ఐటీఆర్ 2 ద స్పెసిఫిక్ ఇన్ఫర్మేషన్ ఆర్ రిక్వైర్డ్ టు కంప్యూట్ ద ట్యాక్సబుల్ ఇన్కమ్ ఫ్రమ్ బై అన్ ఇండివిజువల్ ఆర్ హెచ్యుఎఫ్. ద సోర్సెస్ ఆఫ్ ఇన్కమ్ ఆర్ శాలరీస్, ఇన్కమ్ ఫ్రమ్ హౌస్ ప్రాపర్టీ, క్యాపిటల్ గెయిన్స్, ఇన్కమ్ ఫ్రమ్ అదర్ సోర్సెస్. దీస్ సోర్సెస్ హ్యాస్ టు బి ఇంక్లూడెడ్ ఇన్ ద రిటర్న్ ఆఫ్ ఇన్కమ్. వాట్ ఆర్ ద ఇన్ఫర్మేషన్ అవైలబుల్ ఫర్ శాలరీస్? మీన్స్ హీ హెస్ టు గివ్ ద డీటెయిల్స్ ఆఫ్ ద ఎంప్లాయర్ అండ్ హిస్ నేచర్ ఆఫ్ ఎంప్లాయ్మెంట్, సాలరీ, పర్క్విజిట్స్, ప్రాఫిట్స్ ఇన్ లీ ఆఫ్ సాలరీ, అలవెన్స్ అవైలబుల్ ఎగ్జెంప్షన్, స్టాండర్డ్ డైరెక్షన్స్, ఎంటర్టైన్మెంట్ అలవెన్స్, ప్రొఫెషన్ ట్యాక్స్, టీడీఎస్ మేడ్ అండ్ టీడీఎస్ క్రియేటెడ్. ద సేమ్ వే ఇన్కమ్ ఫ్రమ్ హౌస్ ప్రాపర్టీ మోర్ దెన్ 1 house, ద డీటెయిల్స్ హాస్ టు బి గివెన్ ఆర్ అడ్రస్ ఆఫ్ ద ప్రాపర్టీ, షేర్ ఇన్ ప్రాపర్టీ, నేమ్ ఆఫ్ ద కో ఓనర్ ఇఫ్ ఇట్ ఈస్ ఎ కో ఓనర్ విత్ ఆధార్ నెంబర్, సెల్ఫ్ ఆక్యుపైడ్ లెట్ అవుట్ ఆర్ డీమ్డ్ టు లెట్ అవుట్, ఇఫ్ ద ప్రాపర్టీ ఇస్ లెట్ అవుట్ ద నేమ్ of the tenant with PAN and Aadhaar number and TDS. If the tenant has made TDS, he has to give the details of PAN number and TDS created and also rent received, unrealized rent, taxes paid to local authorities, interest on borrowed capital, arrears realized of previous years. All these details have to be provided in filing the return of income ITR 2. Next comes is capital gains. Capital gains means profit earned on sale of property, a sale or transfer of property. Maybe it is a short-term capital gain or long-term capital gain. Difference for short-term capital gain and long-term capital gain is if the property held for more than 24 months is called long-term capital gain. Earlier it was 36 months. And if it is held for less than 24 months, it is called short-term capital gain. Means earlier it was 36 months. These are the period of holding of the asset decides whether it is a short-term period, short-term capital gain or long-term capital gain. So when it is a short-term capital gain, the taxpayer has to give, if it is a land and building property, he has to give address of the property, sale amount received, and purchaser name and is with Aadhaar number, resale value of the property, when he has cost of the property purchased, any improvement made to the property, the cost of that improvement made, expenditure in connection with transfer, the balance is short-term capital gain. The same way, if it is equity of shares, you have to give the details of full value of share consideration received, cost of acquisition, what is the price paid to purchase those shares, and any addition amount spent, means maybe for rights or any other contribution made, that can be added as cost of improvement, and expenditure on transfer, and the balance will be short-term capital gain. If it is other asset, full value of the consideration received, full value of the consideration for unquoted shares, fair market value of unquoted shares, cost of acquisition, cost of improvement, expenditure for transfer, short-term capital gain, the balance comes to short-term capital gain. And for this, you have to give the details of how the tax compliance has been made. Means there is some exemption, and some short-term capital gains are taxable at 15%, some are taxable at 30%. We have to show separately depending on the nature of assets sold. And in the same way, long-term capital gains means the property held for more than the period prescribed, maybe 36 months or 24 months applicable. If it is immovable property, we have to give the details of sale consideration, stamp duty value of the property. If any difference between the stamp duty value and the sale consideration received, we have to give the detail. And cost of acquisition means what is the purchase price, and cost of improvement, any addition to the asset made. And next, transfer expenditure, all these details has to be provided. And balance is called as long-term capital gain. Details of purchase with PAN number, address and percentage. If it is other assets, we have to mention whether other assets means equity shares, mutual fund units, zero coupon bonds, GDR, listed shares, listed securities, bonds, debentures. We have to give the details of sale consideration, cost of acquisition with indexation, cost of improvement with indexation, transfer expenditure. The balance comes with long-term capital gain. From this long-term capital gain, the eligible deductions are, if the sale price is invested to acquire new residential house, the benefits are available, deduction benefits are available. If the property sold is agricultural land, if it is invested to acquire another agricultural land within a period of 3 years, that is also, their benefits are available. And in notified bonds and new residential house, equity shares in eligible company, all these are eligible for exemption depending upon the property sold, period of use. It could not be invested within 6 months from the date of sale or during the financial year. Then the amount has to be deposited under the capital gains deposit scheme with the any national bank, and that can be used within 3 years to acquire any new residential house, any new agricultural land, residential house to be eligible to claim deduction from long-term capital gains. The same way, if it is for other, the taxpayer is having other source of income, he has to give the general information of what is other sources, maybe interest from banks or income tax refund, rental income from plant and machinery, money received without consideration, property received without consideration of stamp duty. If the property received is without consideration, the stamp duty value, sale consideration received in excess of the stamp duty value, dividends, commission, plot rents, any other income, family pension is also available, comes under other source of income. Incomes which are chargeable at special rates, means some incomes are chargeable at special rates, means higher than normal rates, are flat rate of tax. That is called winning from lotteries and crossword puzzles, unexplained cash credits, unexplained investments, unexplained money, undisclosed investments, unexplained expenditure, amount borrowed or repaid on hundi, accumulated balance in provident fund account, any income from non-residents, any other income chargeable at special rates, income chargeable for non-residents. From these, all these sources of income, there are some deductions allowable that can be claimed. After clubbing all incomes, that is income from salaries, income from house property, income from capital gains, income from other sources, the gross total income comes into computed. From that, the deductions, exemptions allowable are, after claiming exemptions and deductions, the net taxable income will be arrived. From that net taxable income, the adjustment will be made for income taxable set of current year losses. If any current year loss is there, that can be adjusted against this income. And if any brought forward losses are there, that also will be adjusted. And if any loss is there, means after adjusting the current year loss, or if any loss is there, that is to be adjusted, that is to be carried forward to future years, that has to be computed now. And income from specified persons, means baby, spouse or minor child, any asset is in the name of spouse, the consideration is paid by the taxpayer. Though the property is in the name of spouse or a minor child, that will be treated as the property held by the taxpayer, and the income will be added to the income of the taxpayer. Some incomes are taxable at special rates, and other, after that, after anything income is left out, then we have to claim exemptions. In the way, interest, some interests are exempt, and that has to be shown separately. Dividends below 10 lakhs is exempt, and agriculture income up to 5 lakhs. Agriculture is exempt, and if the agriculture income is 5,000 to 5 lakhs, the details has to be given. We have to show the details of sale proceeds, expenditure incurred, and the agriculture, net agriculture income after adjustment of unabsorbed brought forward agriculture loss. And if the agriculture income is declared is more than 5 lakhs, the taxpayer has to give the details separately for each agriculture land, the location of agriculture land, area, own or lease, irrigated or rain fed, all these details has to be given if the agriculture income declared is more than 5 lakhs. And also other exempted income of minor child, incomes exempt under double taxation agreement. And next one is incomes from outside India. There are some tax reliefs to people who are earning income from assets outside India, assets or investments outside India, who are eligible for relief under double taxation avoidance agreement for the tax paid out of India. So relief for tax paid outside India, details of foreign assets and income from outside India, details of assets and liabilities of the, if the income exceeds rupees 50 lakhs. So if the taxpayer is declaring income more than 50 lakhs, means if the taxpayer is having income more than 50 lakhs, he has to provide the details of all his assets and liabilities in the return of income. So that high income taxpayers has to give the details of their net worth, means assets and liabilities in the return of income. I stated earlier, all the returns, how to file the income tax returns. All the returns has to be filed electronically only by, we have to download from the Income Tax India e-filing website, applicable income tax return form ITR 1 or ITR 2, any other ITR, and fill up the details and transmit the details digitally. That will be forwarded to CPC Bangalore, and we have to file ITRV within 120 days. If the PAN card is linked with Aadhaar number, Aadhaar with OTP, if the verification is done with OTP and PAN Aadhaar card linking, the taxpayer need not send ITRV to CPC Bangalore. As stated earlier, to get any refund, even if his income is, if the taxpayer income is less than the taxable limit, if he claims to get the refund of tax has been deducted, maybe from bank or maybe from tenant, or any tax has been deducted, if his income is less than the below threshold limit of 2,50,000, the taxpayer has to file his return of income to claim the refund, what the tax has been deducted on behalf of him by the payers, maybe bankers, tenant, or any person who entered, who carried on business with him. As stated earlier, this income tax return 2, ITR 2, is not applicable to taxpayers who are having business and professional income, companies, partnership firms, non-profit organizations. So this return of income is requiring more and more details compared to earlier returns. All the details are to be digitally formatted. No enclosures are allowed. All the details only in figures, we have to mention that. We have to give all the details only along with return of income. And we cannot make any comment or opinion. Nothing can be added. Everything will be taken care of by CPC Bangalore. If anything, the CPC Bangalore is unable to verify that, they will process the return with under section 1431 and they'll pass the order either accepting the return of income or enhancing the income which is not available or enhancing the demand for the TDS made which was not created or which was not available on the portal of the income tax department, that will not be given credit by the CPC. For that, if it is not available on the portal of the income tax department, the amount will not be given credit to the taxpayer and he will not be eligible for refund or tax credit. So two things will be made by the CPC. One is, if any difference is there in income which is not acceptable to the provisions of Income Tax Act, that will disallow, the income will be added to the income return. And if the TDS or any TCS or any tax credit could not be given because the deductor has not paid, that was not credited to the account of the deductee means taxpayer, the amount will not be given credit. The demand will be raised with the claim made or the refund will be reduced to that extent. So all these details will be provided and the details has to be, if it is not acceptable, the CPC order is not acceptable, the taxpayer has to file an appeal with the respective Commission of Income Tax Appeals within 30 days from the receipt of the order. Means the date of communication is important here. The date of communication, earlier it used to be the receipt of the order, but now it is the mailing of the order itself is treated as the receipt of the order. Means if the CPC Bangalore has sent a mail today, this is the same day is treated as the receipt of order by the taxpayer. Means even if it is sent through post or anything, that the period will not be considered. The mail communication itself is treated as the receipt by the taxpayer, because digital transformation, the taxpayer will get the communication within seconds. So the same date will be considered as the receipt by the taxpayer. So within 30 days, the taxpayer has to act and file an appeal if he feels then the adjustment is not acceptable to him, and he can file with the assessing officer. He can file an appeal with the Commission of Income Tax Appeals. He cannot file anything, any communication with the assessing officer or jurisdiction officer or administrative officer or local officer. The taxpayer can do, the taxpayer can file for revision of the assessment order, means that rectification order. If it is not considered by the CPC, then he can go for appeal also. Two options are available, one to file for rectification with the CPC or file an appeal with the Commission of Income Tax Appeals. These are the details. This is the latest position for filing the income tax returns by taxpayers.